southern Italy and the beautiful Campania region, which will be our backdrop for the next 11 days of sporting drama and endeavour. Since Turin hosted the first Universiade, it is the turn of Naples to put on the show, and they have quite a show for us tonight. The President of Italy is here. Now we begin the countdown proper. And I can promise you the next 2.5 hours will be full of colour and drama. After all, this is Naples.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the opening ceremony of the 30th Summer Universiade, Napoli 2019.
There are two recurring themes to this opening ceremony: Vesuvius the volcano and the sparkling bay of Naples. Both will be ever present in the stadium tonight. And the show begins at the beginning, which is always a good thing, the beginning of Naples. And the siren Parthenope was washed up on the shore, where fishermen found her body, laid her to rest under the gaze of Vesuvius, her body morphing into the fishing village that was to become Naples. This will seem like a walk in the park for her. On this show is that U shape that takes up half the playing area of the stadium. And those chairs, all 6,000 of them, will be filled by athletes once they've paraded through the stadium.
Please welcome the athletes of the 30th Summer Universiade Napoli 2019.
And so begins the great athletes parade. We have 6,000 of them from 125 countries to get through. Every continent represented with athletes from every one of the 18 sports competed for here in Naples. There are 20 nations here with teams of 100 or more students, and Brazil is one of them. 116 in total. Guess in which sport they have the greatest number of athletes and players. Football. 20 men, 20 women bringing their samba football to the games.
Costa d'Avorio.
That's Nikolai Hartling, who's competing in athletics, and he's leading 50 athletes for Denmark. Most of them actually are competing in athletics. Bakauri is definitely one to watch in the judo. Here come the Germans, led out by Liang Q, German university table tennis champion, participating in his third Summer Universiade. Mexico being led out by Dolores Hernandez, a diver, getting a big cheer from the Italian fans here.
Russian Federation, Federazione Russa.
Kirill Prigoda is their flag bearer, world champion swimmer. And he leads out the third largest team here in Naples, despite them not competing in athletics. But they are competing in every other sport. Athletes from Great Britain competing in nine sports. Water polo is the only team sport the country's competing in, and there's a strong contingent from Loughborough and Edinburgh universities aiming for medals in this swimming. Now, the women's basketball team is an interesting story. The USA's women's basketball team failed to win a medal in the last Summer Universiade, despite being amongst the favourites. And this time, they say they are on a mission to avenge that defeat 2 years ago. And they'll be represented by Mississippi State University team. The first time that that university is representing its country in a Universiade. The crowd have worked out that this procession is coming to a climax with the host team, Italy, making its way out of the tunnel, working their way towards the centre of the stadium.
National University Sports Federation President, Oleg Matitsin.
Your Excellency, President Sergio Mattarella. Dear friends, dear athletes, buonasera. Benvenuti to the 30th Summer Universiade of the International University Sports Federation. Some of you have traveled from far away, others from places that are closer. But in coming to Italy, all of our journeys have connected with the history of university sport and also with the future. It is here in Italy that Universiade started 60 years ago. From dear athletes, FISU wishes you every success in the coming days. Not all of you will finish with the medal, but please remember that the biggest victory is one available to all of you, the chance to leave Napoli as a better person. Respect the effort of those who have helped you achieve your goal of being here tonight. And respect yourself too, by playing fairly. The way in which you compete will always be more important than the result. Finally, before we listen to the welcome address from the IOC President, Dr. Thomas Bach, in a few short moments. Please, remember that so many have worked so hard to make all of this possible. Perhaps you might allow me to send the example with an expression of gratitude for all of the work of the organizers of this Summer Universiade. Country of Italy, Region Campania, Napoli, and of course our great FISU team.
Mr. President of the Italian Republic, Your Excellency Sergio Mattarella, dear FISU President Oleg Matizzi, dear athletes, buonasera Napoli. This evening marks the beginning of something special for all athletes. Over the coming days of competition, you will give it your best, make new friends, and take an important step for your sporting future. This Universiade will be your moment to shine in the sport you love so much. To all the athletes, I say, always compete in the Olympic spirit of friendship, respect, and fair play. Most importantly, enjoy every moment of this incredible experience. And who knows, perhaps Napoli will be the beginning of your journey to the Olympic Games Tokyo 2020. From my own experience of competing at the Universiade during my student days, as you can see, not too long ago, I know one thing for sure. You will make memories that will last a lifetime. As Napoli welcomes university athletes from around the world, let me congratulate FISU on the 60th anniversary of the Universiade. What better occasion to return to Italy than to celebrate this remarkable milestone. You in FISU have every reason to look back on an impressive history of inspiring university students with the values of sport. I wish you all the best for at least the next 60 years and beyond. And now enjoy this Universiade and celebrate the special moments that only sport can give us all.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the Italian Republic, Sergio Mattarella.
Nella certezza che questo grande evento sportivo contribuirà a rafforzare i legami di amicizia tra i popoli del mondo, dichiaro aperta la 30ª edizione della Universiade estiva Napoli 2019.
Gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to the International University Sports Federation flag carried by Italian outstanding academics and sports legends. Signor.
Now they're going to do this differently. For the first time in a Universiade, the FISU flag of the International
Klaus
Federation of University Sports
former diver and Olympic
will
gold
be carried
medal
not just by athletes but by four
games.
University researchers too.
Klaus Di Biasi, tuffatore, medaglia d'oro in tre.
Antonietta Di Martino, Italian high jump record holder and six times champion.
Antonietta Di Martino.
Real emphasis at these games on the importance that sport and education together can bring.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the International University Sports Federation anthem.
First sign.
Signore e signori.
First sung at the 1959 Universiade, and it's all in Latin, but we're going to get a modern twist on it tonight. Local boy, an X-Factor competitor, Andrea D'Alessio, bringing the anthem into the 21st century. coming now is a tribute to the sports of the 30th Summer Universiade. And the judokas that you can see running on to the stage there have been drawn from a club set up in the underprivileged Scampia neighbourhood of Naples to help young people out of poverty and away from crime. The emphasis in this part of the show is the energy that we can all get from sport. Captain of Napoli and Italy at his home stadium in front of his home fans.
Capitano del Napoli e attaccante della nazionale italiana.
Such huge names of kickballs on this hallowed turf. Zoff, Cannavaro, Carreca, Cavani, Maradona. They've all played here and hit the target. No pressure. No pressure at all, Mr. Insigne. The flaming football flies from the San Paolo Stadium and flies towards Vesuvius. and you'll notice it's not actually a burning flame. This is a sustainable cauldron. It's all lights. No fuel being burnt at these Universiades, in the cauldron anyway.
Ladies and gentlemen, Andrea Bocelli.
So the games and the party can begin. Classic Neapolitan song, Funiculi, Funicula, inspired by the inauguration of the first funiculate to reach the top of Vesuvius in the night. The crowd are on their feet for Andrea Bocelli. Now, the Neapolitans love their fireworks, and we will finish tonight with a firework display over the city as Vesuvius burns inside the San Paolo Stadium. Well, it's been a great show involving over 450 production staff behind the scenes from 19 different nations, and it's set up beautifully a fortnight of sporting action. Naples is ready. 6,000 athletes are in the blocks, ready and steady to go. From me, Alec Wilkinson, from the San Paolo in Naples, it's ciao ciao.